Evidence for God. Definition.
Theism is the hypothesis that God exists, as intelligent mind that created the physical universe. Atheism is the hypothesis that God does not exist. In science, evidence for a hypothesis is an observation that is consistent with what we would naturally expect, or predict, to be the case, if the hypothesis were true. And, evidence against a hypothesis is an observation that contradicts what we would naturally expect, or predict, to be the case, if the hypothesis were true. Or an observation that comes as a surprise, if that hypothesis were true. In science, the statement, "there is evidence for a given hypothesis," means that there are observations, or data, that are consistent with the predictions of, or the natural expectations of, the hypothesis. And, the statement, "there is evidence against a given hypothesis," means that there are observations, or data, that contradict, or come as a surprise to, the predictions of, or the natural expectations of, the hypothesis.
Evidence.
In the sense described above, there are millions of observations in the physical universe that are more naturally to be expected if God existed, compared to if he did not, and atheism were true.
1.
And, in that sense, we have provided plenty of evidence for the existence of God, as mind that created the physical universe, in several videos. These include, A. The Big Bang, B. The fine-tuning of the Big Bang, C. The extreme fine-tuning of 30 to 50 physical parameters to enable complex life to exist in the universe. D. The presence of complex independently specified functional information, CISFI, in the simplest self-replicator, needed for origin of life. CISFI is proof of intelligent design. E. The presence of semantic information, indicating intelligent design, at the origin of life.
F.
The presence of algorithmic information, indicating intelligent design, at the origin of life. G. The presence of CISFI at the origin of each of the higher taxa. H. The presence of semantic information at the origin of each of the higher taxa. I. The presence of algorithmic information at the origin of each of the higher taxa.
J.
The non-material non-computability of mind.
K.
The non-material non-computability of free will.
L.
The existence of non-material causal agents.
M.
The presence of languages in DNA-RNA protein systems.
N.
The presence of language-to-language translators in DNA-RNA protein systems.
O.
The presence of software in such systems.
P.
The presence of software error-checking systems in DNA-RNA protein systems.
Q. The presence of software modules in genomes.
R.
The use of modular software design principles in genomes.
S.
The presence of addressing meta-information in genomes and cells.
T. The presence of address recognition systems in genomes and cells.
U.
The modification and reuse of software modules in genomes.
V.
The transfer of software modules within and across genomes.
W.
The use of information compression methods in genomes.
X.
The presence of foresight and intelligent planning for the future in genomes.
All of these items are evidence, in the sense defined at the start of this video, that point to purposeful and intelligent design of the universe, and of the laws of physics, and of the origin of life, and of the biosphere.
So, ultimately, all of these point to the existence of God.
2.
In addition, we have provided a logical proof for the existence of God, in a previous video. So, it is completely false for an atheist to claim that there is no evidence for God.
3.
In science, it is completely valid to infer the existence of an unseen entity based on its effects on physical reality. E.g., electrons, protons, positrons, magnetic fields, electric fields, photons, the existence of my mind, the existence of other minds, the existence of my free will, the existence of the free will of other humans, the existence of my consciousness, the existence of the consciousness of other humans.
4. So, it is completely valid to infer the existence of God as an unseen entity, based on the observed effects, listed in item 1 above, in physical reality.
5. In science, we use induction as a logical method to infer the existence of unseen entities, mentioned above.
6.
So, it is completely valid to infer the existence of God as an unseen entity, based on induction.
7.
In science, it is completely valid to infer the past action of an unseen entity based on its effects on physical reality. E.g., the activity of animal minds, based on behavioral inferences from burrowing fossils, or nesting fossils, or socially congregated fossils, etc.
8. So, it is completely valid to infer the past action of God, based on the effects listed in item 1 above.
9. In science, it is completely valid to infer the past action of a mind based on its effects on physical reality, e.g., the activity of animal minds, based on behavioral inferences from burrowing fossils, or nesting fossils, or socially congregated fossils, etc.
10. So, it is completely valid to infer the past action of God, as mind, based on the effects listed in item 1 above. Conclusion.
1. We have provided lots of evidence for the existence of God, listed above, and discussed in previous videos.
2.
And, we use the same methods that are used in science, to infer the existence of unseen entities, and to infer the existence of past minds, and the past action of minds, to infer the existence of God, as mind that created physical reality.
3. So, it is completely false and intellectually vacuous for dogmatic atheists to insist that there is no evidence for God, i.e., that there is no evidence that is consistent with the hypothesis that God exists.
Thanks for watching. Please like, share, and subscribe.